I'm really excited, really proud. And it's been a long time coming because we've had our snags along the way with regard to funding for this project. But people have rallied round and we've eventually got here. Yeah, good day for Meriden. Well, I think for too long the residents have had a rundown centre that, you know, there were some good things going on in it, but it actually wasn't doing anything for the area. So this is actually saying, Meriden, your Premier League. You know, it's actually about good facilities that make people feel proud they've got that in their area. We've done work on the play equipment around here, you know, so we're trying to upgrade the area because I want people to feel proud of where they live. And so I think this is really significant for that. And to have our football club as our main partner is just the icing on the cake and the cherry on the top. And that's the really important message. This is for everyone. I mean, we've got an art class in there at the moment, and lots of senior citizens and the odd young person painting away with good instruction. And then you've got everybody out on the pitch. So it is a true community centre. But the important thing is we've got high calibre of our club behind this, so it will succeed. And it was lovely to have a good luck message from Anthony Joshua, who is a Meriden lad himself, our world champion boxer, to say actually you can aspire. And I think this says aspiration, and that's my vision for the town, and I couldn't be prouder than having our club as our as the main tenant, because of course I'm a landlady. Council, we couldn't. We had looked at all our community centres and we said, actually, we need community centres to move with the times, to reflect what people actually need them to do now in the 21st century. We've got different partners for our community centres, and Leslie, who's sitting there, was very much the drive behind that, one of our officers. And the vision and the idea for the Meriden was born. We were an excited group of people. And we actually thought, actually, at the time I thought, this will be a Premier League partnership. It's been a tough road. I think actually we'd both be the first to admit that we've had ups and downs with funding. And we've been absolutely delighted that we've been able to put money into this, and indeed our wonderful partners, Watford Community Housing Trust, people from there are here today. So to the trustees, I'd say thank you for sticking with the vision for this part of our town. Because what we get here is something that is very local, and local people will come here, they will grow to love it like they used to love the old centre. And Natasha, who will be Queen of the Meriden, has told me that all the old groups have come back except one, and they've found another community centre of ours, and they're happier there. That's great, everyone's a winner. But it will also have town-wide significance. Because of the club, and because of the work that the Trust do, this will be a real flagship. And when I found out that Harrow had got something, you can imagine what I said to them. You know, hello, we are Watford. So it's been a while coming, but it has been a testimony to the good partnerships between us all, and you and your ward and your trustees, Rob, that we are where we are today. It's going to be a little flagship for this area, but it'll actually be quite special for the whole town too. So thank you very much for sharing with us.
Change can be scary, and it brings with it the fear of the unknown. But But for us, our plans for the centre have always been consistent. To work with key partners and funders to improve the facilities on the centre side and develop a vibrant community hub. Secondly, to provide the chance for individuals, clubs and organisations to hire areas for community activities, arts, music, as well as physical activity and sport. And thirdly, to enable the Trust to create opportunities which promote health and well-being and improve life chances and skills by inspiring and motivating those we engage with. Staff at other charities and football clubs asked why we bother to get involved in community facilities. Well, for us there are a couple of reasons. Firstly, Watford FC is about more than just football. It has a proud heritage as a family and community club, built over several decades. In case you weren't aware, next season we'll be celebrating 25 years of work in the community, and that's only from the point in which the club first appointed a football in the community officer. Yet in truth, the club's involvement with the community stretches back much further than the 90s, and this needs to be credited to ex-Watford FC manager and Trust patron, Graham Taylor. We're very pleased that Graham has been able to join us today. Many know Graham for his success as a Watford manager and what was achieved on the pitch. Graham's achievements off the pitch, though, were groundbreaking at the time. He introduced the first family stand at a stadium. He insisted players lived as local as they could to the football ground. And he introduced clauses in their contracts which committed them to making appearances at community activities. We are fortunate in that the current chief executive, Scott Duxbury, and the owner, Gino Pozzo, understand the club's heritage and continue to embrace Watford as a family and community club. This means the club continues to take its role in the community seriously, recognising the positive contribution it can make. Secondly, our vision in the Trust is improving lives and enhancing communities, and our mission statement is making a positive difference through supported learning. A project like this enables our staff, through passion, enthusiasm and hard work, to deliver our vision. It also helps us to further measure the impact our work is having in local communities, something we take very seriously. But with the help and financial support from partners, we have been able to breathe new life into what was a very tired and rundown centre. We will also now look to see if funding can be secured for the final phase, which is to install a new play area outside main entrance. If you're able to help us in any way, we'd welcome a conversation about that. On behalf of the Trust, it's only right that I take this opportunity to thank some more people and organisations for helping us to get where we are today. A thanks go to Hearts FA, and especially Carl Lingham, for his support with our bid for funding towards the artificial grass pitch. Thanks to Hilton Worldwide and Wicks for committing staff time to volunteering and skill sharing days, and to Muriel Construction Limited for donating the bike racks. I'd like to thank the first team players here today, Troy, Aurelio and Jerome, for supporting today's event and their ongoing support for our community work. The Premier League and FA Facilities Fund, we have Nick here from the Premier League, really grateful for your support. I'm hugely grateful to all the Trust team, and especially the centre staff, Tasha, Sally, Richard, Nick and Debbie, who have been extremely patient and remained enthusiastic throughout the build period, and will no doubt play an important role in the success of the centre moving forward. Thanks also to Christian, our Marketing and Communications Officer, many of you would have met him today, for organising much of today, and a huge thanks to Steve Williams, who's been the Trust Project Manager at this site, given up many, many months of his time looking after our interests, the club's interests and all of the key partners' interests to make sure we've had a successful completion for the building. I make no apology in finishing by thanking our funders and partners. We're extremely grateful to Sport England, Watford Borough Council, in particular Manny Lewis, Leslie, Chris Fennell, who have supported us throughout. The Football Foundation, Watford Community Housing Trust, especially Tina Barnard and Gareth Lewis, and of course the club's commitment to this project. Without your help and support, this project would not have become a reality. Thank you once again for coming. Just wanted to show you a brief film, which hopefully brings to life the work that's gone over.